Sarmata, you and I shall be together until we die. Do you understand what that means?
Duh, I'm not stupid. It means we'll be stuck with each other until we drop dead, right?
No, you don't understand at all. Oh, you are my fiancé, you know. At least pretend to have a modicum of intelligence.
No, I don't want to die with you.
Jeez, look at Kanada. Totally zoning out right now.
Snap out of it! Stop staring into space!
I had thought everything would stay the same forever. It wasn't Yamatoga or Amatsume's fault. Being there just put a spotlight on it. Somehow, when I wasn't looking, I changed.
And the record for years in a row without getting Valentine's chocolate keeps growing, folks. I've gotten exactly zero today.
Not surprising, seeing as you basically belong to Ranze. But none of the other girls would dare cross her. Why do you have to bitch about this every year? More importantly, thanks to my hard work, I got chocolate from no less than 10 hopefuls.
Yeah, because you're a sleazy womanizer. Koharu's pretty pissed at you about it.
Random conversations at school. Why would I be hearing that now? For how important these essence crystals are, they're pretty random.
They speak only to their owners. Not everything they say will have meaning.
What the hell? That's a letdown.
When you spoke with Myra long ago, you brought up synesthesia, correct? Whether you find a thing meaningful or meaningless is up to you.
Dude, what right do you have to even get chocolates? You have the one girl every guy in the whole school wants, and they hate you for it.
Our parents decided all that. Not like we had any say in the matter. You can't change the world, so you just have to adapt to it, right?
Well, you seem to be okay with it, or at least resigned. But to be honest, I'd trade places with you in a heartbeat.
What are you grumbling about? If you want chocolate that badly, I'll gladly buy... Wait, never mind. Any kind of Valentine chocolate would be wasted on you.
What? I take it some of the crystal's words are hitting close to home.
No, I wasn't just being objective. I hadn't given up either. I just figured there was no changing the world, and I was okay with that. There wasn't any need for me to change it.
We kept the damage to a minimum.
I'm getting better.
Take up arms, ye who bear two souls!
I will be your opponent.
Hurt.
That is what they call a piece of cake.
Awaken ye who stand 'twixt life and death!
Let's get this started.
What's your problem, Koharu? I'm doing what I'm supposed to. My grades are good enough, right? Why would they be pissed at me?
Hey, I'm trying to warn you, you know? You could at least pay attention to me.
Koharu Nagi, stop interrupting class!
Ugh, he's way too soft on you, Kanata.
It's weird listening to myself like this. It's like I'm someone else. I did used to think I could slide by doing only the bare minimum. It's the person I am now that's the total stranger. I wonder what Ranze thinks of the new me.
Awaken ye who stand twixt life and death!
Is it my turn yet?
Hope you're watching me, Grandpa.
Sage's crown!
That wasn't my fault. Here comes the enemy. You disappoint me. Damage to a minimum. Bring out a big attack!
Sage's crown!
Piece of cake.
Amatsume said essence crystals are a wish to connect, crystallized. So why is the voice I'm hearing always my own? Is my old self somehow trying to connect with this new me?
It doesn't have to be voices at all. You could hear nothing but the wind. What matters is how you perceive it.
All I'm finding out is that I didn't really know myself at all.
What an amazingly dull epiphany. I have no desire to know the real me. I do what I want, when I want. This is how I shall be for eternity.
That's insane. Nobody could live life like that. No human, anyway. Anyway, I think I learned something else just now. Asking why or any other question was pointless right now. What I needed to do was change and adapt. By doing that, maybe I'd become the person I always thought I was.
Yes! The team is all together once again! Great work, everyone!
Koharu, you came here together with Mitsuhide, correct?
Yep, both of us totally panicked. It was such a mess!
I thought Mitsuhide would have been able to keep it together at least.
Pretty sure anyone would have panicked at first.
You think? You must have absolutely lost your mind, I'm sure.
You bet I did! Who wouldn't?
This is what happens when you don't take emergency drills seriously.
Who runs emergency drills for getting warped to a different planet?
The basic idea is still the same.
You know, I thought I knew just how unflappable you really were. But I didn't think you were essentially a robot.
You just panicked too easily, that's all.
If you say so.